This is the day that the Lord has made. Bless God. What's going on, y'all? Today, all right, so I got a new camera, right? And a little stand, but right now I'm in the car. I'm on my way to go hoop. I'm gonna see y'all when we get there, but yeah. All right, so I made it to the gym, but what I was saying though was with this camera, I had it for a little while. I had pulled it out and I was like, all right, let me see how it was looking. It's not too bad of a camera, I think. I'm gonna try to compare it a little bit to my phone. I was using my phone before, but anyway, we here, we at the gym. I also got a tripod. I also got the little stand for the camera. So what we gonna do is today, I'm probably not gonna get no footage in there. Maybe not, cause man, this camera is chugging right now. Like I was just using the camera and it had one bar, but now it's full again. See, I don't know. So I might get some footage, I might not. We gonna see. But right now, we can just call this a little trial run for the camera. You feel me? We're gonna see what we get on the camera. I'm gonna try to get some footage for y'all regardless, you know? And yeah, let's go. Let's go with the day. Yo, so we're in the gym right now. But hey, but hey, when it comes to these shoes, man, these shoes are here, man. I already had the switch them up again. But yeah, we got another pair that we're about to run through again. Everybody see what we got going on today, man. We got us some runs today. Let's go. So what's going on, guys? It's a couple days later. But for the rest of the video, I'm just gonna really be getting into basically a type of cleansing. While reading the Bible, I've read a lot, and I've seen that it talks about how we are redeemed through Christ, and basically it's by His blood which we have washed. And I just came up with the idea of basically like a type of cleansing of like of the past, you know. But it also talks a little bit about the past. Paul was talking about to just forget about the past. Yeah, we're new creations every day. So today, what I was thinking of doing is basically I went through some of my things that I was going to be burning away. I couldn't throw it away too, you know, but I was thinking, you know, just burning it, just to actually, you know, yeah, burn it. And seeing that today we finally got us a night. It's pretty cold up here in Florida. It's not cold all the time, but right now I don't know the weather. But yeah, I'm gonna just try to start the little fire, try to keep warm, and I'm gonna also be doing a little reading. And we're gonna get into it. So to start the fire, I just put a little gasoline in there a little earlier, and I got this some sparkler from, you know, fireworks and stuff. Lighter or anything, so I'm gonna try to light this on the stove. Yeah, let's see how it goes. Alright, so I couldn't get the sparkler to go off, but I actually ended up using the insert. The sparkler probably would have been a bad idea. Think about it, you know, like sparkler. But the interesting thing about incense, it also talks about incense in the Bible as well. Let's see if we can get into that. Let's see if we can get this started here.
got us a flame. Definitely got us a flame. So it's not so cold out here anymore. Just do a little reading now. I was gonna be reading. I didn't have anything set up today. I had something this morning. We could also start with add some stuff in here. This here is just some stuff from my case right here. I had a case. Still fighting with this. It's the old stuff. Get out of the car with that. It's been a lot. It's been a lot I've been going through recently. I was incarcerated. I had some clothes. A lot of stuff. When I was in there, I was writing a lot, trying to keep up with the road, things of that nature. They had activities for us, stuff like that. Program and they kicked me out and they gave me nothing but a bag like this, right? A paper bag, a brown paper bag with all of my stuff. And like, I had to walk home and everything. Like, I'm walking home, I'm sweating and whatnot. And like, the brown paper bag is ripping, all my stuff is just falling out and whatnot. I'm trying to figure out a way. I had to grab like a plastic bag, I had to ask somebody for like a plastic bag. They had one. If I use a plastic bag, I was walking around with a plastic bag eventually. But this is still that same bag for me. So they kicked me out of the program for some reason. It didn't even make sense. It was weird. When I think back on it, it's just crazy how it happened. Say how we are redeemed. We are His. We are sons in Christ Jesus. And that's what I'm going to be dealing with today. How we are sons in Christ Jesus. While I'm learning things out of my life and just basically becoming new. How the Bible says, we're new creatures every day. That's just what I'm trying to get into. Okay, we have here, it says, in 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sin, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sin and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. That's found in 1 John 1:9. I'm going to keep going. From this, I just see that basically, we're not perfect. We do find ourselves in sin, living in a world of sin. And while living in this world, we have to look up to God and really search His word, seek His kingdom, and figure out what is righteous in His eyes, not what man say is righteous or what is right. Because they will mislead you. They will us need. It's a lot of things that we see on TV, even like we see a lot of injustice, even with the police system. It's crazy, really crazy. I'm gonna be burning this. This is my swimsuit, actually. Okay, so this is, I'm not gonna burn this either. This is the Bible I was reading while I was incarcerated. It didn't be a Bible. I found this Bible and I was reading from it. And this one has pictures. It has a timeline and things of that sort. And I'm gonna actually try to get back into this one too. Glad that I actually put it back up. But this is a good one. I'm gonna try and get back into this. The New American Bible. I'm trying to get back into that. I was also writing while I was in there. I couldn't even send any letters. I couldn't do anything while I was in there. It was crazy. Getting in there, it was crazy. It was crazy. I also had here I had my ankle monitor that I had when I was incarcerated, when they let me out at first. I still have the ankle monitor, and I was gonna also torch this too. It was a crazy time. The police officer, he lied on me, and that caused me to be incarcerated. It was a crazy time. Really just trying to stay focused, you know. It's been tough. Trying to live in a world of sin, you know. So now it looks like flames went out, and trying to start that fire, man, you wouldn't believe. Let me try to get this back on real quick. Be right back in chat. I actually found some matches that I can just try it. We left off. I think we were talking about just cleansing things of that nature and how to incarcerate it. Kind of cool out here, man. How the scream had picked up. I was just thinking if I put my hand in there. I'm gonna keep reading off what we have here about cleansing. Acts chapter 2, verse 38, it says, Peter said to them, repent and be baptized. Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peter was just talking about basically repenting, turning away from this thing. Repenting also requires understanding as well. Understanding that the sins that you committed were wrong, and that that you should repent and turn away from them. That is what repentance is, to sorrow. That's what it was talking about in Acts. Just abiding in Christ, things of that nature. Abiding to the laws, even the laws of the land, they were created for a reason. Although we may find that some people may believe themselves to be above the law, which is just still try to definitely understand the law. And as long as we are following God's laws, then we can continue on and follow their laws as well. As long as it's in accordance to the Lord's law, then we can definitely follow. Now what I'm actually throwing in here is this was from my last job. I feel like God really revealed himself to me in a way I didn't understand at the time. I ended up losing the job. It was a bad job, but like the way I lost it was interesting. I found myself kind of a slight injury, right? And I let them know that I was injured, and I ended up losing the job because I couldn't do a drug test. I was trying to do the drug test, and for some reason I just could not do it. Like, it was crazy. But after everything happened, God gave me rest, because the job, it was a little overbearing, and I feel like God gave me rest from that job. And now, it's a little better. It's a lot better, I think, actually. It doesn't require as much. I'm really glad that how everything has been moving. God has just been revealing himself in little ways to me, and even big ways as well. One of the verses I read just now is in Second Timothy, I believe. Just talking about how at a certain point in the world, the devil is going to be trying to force you to bend. He's going to try to bend you to do his will, basically, is what the devil is going to be doing, right? So I found myself in a position where I've been being attacked by the devil, the demons, and it has been a lot that I have been going through for the past month or so. It's been almost 2 years now that I've been going through this. But it has drawn me closer to God, to his word. I'm thankful for that, but it has been overbearing. But I feel like with God, we can push through anything. So I'm not really worried about it. When I say the devil is out here and we just need to be wary, we just really do, because it's been crazy how he would attack. With my new job, it has been going great. been going great. I don't know, I might keep this because for my new job, I use these, so probably switch it out. I gotta get more uniform. Then I'm trying to get a new uniform for the men, but I work tomorrow too. We'll see how it goes. But yeah, that's where I've been. That's where I've been doing all for me. Maybe 2 years. Let's see what else we can find out. Okay, so here in Colossians 3, I said, put to death, therefore, what is earthly in you, which is sexual immortality, immorality, impurity, passion, evil desire, covetousness, which is idolatry. Those are things that we should put to death inside of them. Although this is externally, I still find it to be cleansing because although it is externally, it is also cleansing me internally as well. Basically, as far as my mind, when you may pass by something, it may reflect, cause you memories or flashbacks for you. I would definitely say, want to let go of anything from the past. Because me myself, I'm a sinner. I've repented, and all I can do is continue to turn to God. That's all I can do. I'm gonna read one more and probably end off the video here. I had to basically control myself, stay sober-minded, and really just turn to God. Another one here, it's not necessarily about cleansing, but it says here, Colossians, do not regard him as an enemy, but warn him as a brother or a sister. So here I'm going to end the video off. Peace and grace be unto you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Seeing y'all, man, in the next video. Let me know if you like this video. And I'm gonna be seeing y'all in the next one. Peace. Oh.